going to start with the workbook. It was only the lesson C, right? Because we didn't finish with the lesson B. Oh, and it was the second part of B?
Yes.
Also, yes.
The sobreloading.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's page one. Yes, it's the one. Yeah. In exercise two says, look at the pictures and complete the questions with one or one same right answers using at least two adjectives. Okay, number one is your example. I like the Thai sofa. Which one do you like? Oh, I like the big Italian one. Number two, Aide?
I like the wider dresser, which...
Why?
Why dresser which one do you like? También tengo lo de abajo. I like the which dresser. Black.
Well, if you wanna say okay, I like the black.
Like black dresser, which one?
No, pay attention to the answer. Pay attention to the number one. It says, I like the big Italian one. Now, what is your answer in number two?
I like gris dresser, black. With white dresser?
Black or white? You have to choose only
white. White dresser?
White dresser. Remember that we can't repeat the name of the item. That's why you can use one or once. One more time, pay attention to the exercise one, Aide. I like the big Italian one, and we are not saying sofa.
Okay.
We are just describing the sofa. So your answer is, I like
white dresser one?
No. Oh. I didn't remember, if you say the name of the item, you cannot say one or once.
One.
You are changing. Remember, you are changing the name of the item. So again, try to do it. I like
white dresser one.
One more time. Don't say the name of the object.
I like white. What?
Pay attention here. Uh-huh. You can say letter A. I like the white dresser, or I like the white one. You have two options. Yes, can you see?
Yeah.
Now, which one do you like? I like that. Say the color.
White.
The white.
White one.
Yes, just like that. I like the white one.
Okay.
I like the black one or the brown one.
Okay.
Only like that. So let's continue with number three, Marla.
I like the square mirrors. Which ones do you like?
Uh-huh.
Not really. I like the oval ones.
Correct. And number four, Karina.
I love the big clock.
Which
one do you like? I like the small one.
Excellent. Correct. Now let's continue with this part. Okay, exercise. So the exercise three. Okay, here it says, unscramble the sentences about Susan's living room. Just let me adjust here. Okay. And number one says, there is a small red sofa in her living room. Number two, Marla.
She has cool squares on cushion on the sofa.
Number three, Karina.
There's beautiful Japanese end table.
Can you repeat again, please, Karina? I can hear you.
There's beautiful Japanese.
Japanese?
Japanese end table.
On the left.
The left.
The left, uh-huh. Number four, Aide.
She a big TV on the wall. Porque está, no se ve.
Pay attention to the screen.
She.
Uh-huh. She.
She has.
Mm-hmm.
She has a black. No, no. She has a big TV.
What?
She has a big TV. No. She has She has a black TV.
Black no. Or big? You were saying?
Big TV.
You have to use all the words, Aide. She has a big...
Big TV?
What is the other adjective?
On the wall?
Black? What is black? Okay, she has a big
TV, no, black TV.
One more time, she has a big
TV.
Aide, you need to use the adjectives, Aide. You are using only one adjective. You have two.
Black.
So one more time. She has a big.
Black.
But try to say it complete. Please, Aide. She has a big.
She's a big black.
One more time. She a big or she has a big.
She has a big TV.
And where is black? So she has a big, huh?
She's a big.
Aide, what are you saying? She a big. What is the verb, Aide?
She?
She is a verb?
No, on the wall.
On the wall is a verb? So one more time. She, okay, what are you saying? She. And then?
A.
A is correct. She, a.
She has.
Okay, she has. Uh-huh.
Big.
She has a big
black
TV. Yes.
On the wall.
On the wall, like that. Okay, number five. Marla.
There's long, dark, a coffee table in front of sofa.
There's long, dark, a coffee table. No. There's, one more time, there's.
Dark, long. There's a long, dark coffee table in front of sofa.
Coffee table in front of, the sofa, correct. And Karina, the last one, please.
There are nice cotton.
Okay, there,
Are nice.
There are, and we need some. There are some.
Nice. Cotton. On the floor.
Okay, so one more time. There are some.
Nice.
Nice.
Cotton. Cotton. Rugs.
Rugs, yes.
On the floor.
Excellent. That's it. Perfect. Just let me raise the lines. I think Julio was here. Julio, how are you, Julio?
¿Dónde estás? ¿Dónde estás?
Julio.
Ah, estoy en mi azotea porque allá abajo me sacaron de mi cuarto.
¿Why?
Me sacaron de mi cuarto, estoy en mi azotea. Ahí está el sol. Estaba platicando.
¿Why are you over there, Julio?
Estaba platicando con el sol.
Ay, Julio, Julio.
I talking the sun.
You are talking to the sun?
Yes.
Okay, well, let's continue with letter C. Do you mind?
Yes.
It's a couple of questions with do you mind or do you mind if? Number one, do you mind if I borrow your dictionary? No, not at all. Go ahead. Number two, okay, Julio, let's do it. Number two.
Do you mind if answering the phone for me? Oh, no, no problem.
Can you repeat again, please, Julio? I can hear you.
Do you mind if answering the phone for me? Oh, no, no problem.
No, that is not correct. Pay attention to the verb, Julio. The verb is in gerund. We have ing. Answering.
Is.
We're going to use would.
Entonces,
would you mind?
Would you mind? Ah, okay. Answering the phone for me? Oh, no, no problem.
Excellent. Number four, Karina. I'm sorry, three, Karina.
Would you mind closing that door? No at all.
Okay, number four, Aide.
Do you mind if I take off my shoes? No, go right ahead.
Ahead. Excellent. Marla.
Ah, no se la escuchó, profe.
Number five, Marla.
Do you mind if I use computer for a minute? No problem.
Correct. Number six, Julia.
Would you mind handing me the potato? So, hola. Of course, no. Here you are.
Number seven, Karina.
Would you mind playing that song again? You'd be happy to.
Okay. Number eight, Aide.
Do you mind if I eat the last piece of a people piece? No, at all. Go ahead.
Okay, one more piece of apple pie. Try to repeat.
Piece of apple pie.
Number nine, Julio.
Do you mind if I turn on the news for a minute? No, not alone.
Correct. Number 10, Karina.
Would you mind turning down the music a little? No problem. Is this okay now?
Yes, excellent. I think this part is very easy. Very simple. Okay, now let's move with the exercise two. It's a circle the correct responses to complete the conversation. Let's see. Okay. We have mother and Rudy. Okay, Marla, you're going to be the mother. Karina, you're going to be Rudy. Okay?
Rudy, can I talk to you?
Sure. You don't sound too happy. What's the matter?
If your room is a mess, could you please clean it before your grandparents get here?
Okay. I can do it now.
Oh, and would you mind taking your wedding training things of your living room?
No, but do you mind if after I clean my room?
Sure, I'd be happy to. Actually, I should probably call your grandparents to make sure they're not lost. Do you know their cell phone number?
Yeah, I'd go it on my phone.
Oh, in the case, can I borrow your phone?
Sure, go ahead.
Where is it?
Oh, I don't know. I think it's here somewhere.
Okay. Only hearing this expression, Marla, the pronunciation is in that case.
That case?
In that case, yes. And here, Karina, is I've got it.
I've got it.
And the second one, in that case. Well, now let's continue with the exercise three. This is the last part. It says respond to this request and add more information. Just let me erase here. So number one is your example. I don't usually stay up this late. Would you mind bringing me some coffee? No, of course not, but I have to make some first. Number two, Julio, can you do it, please?
Do you mind if I come over to your house tonight? I want to watch the soccer game. Sure, go ahead. I'd be happy.
Okay, number three, Karina.
These tacos are really spicy. Could you get me a glass of the water? Sure. I buy a cake for dessert.
Okay, excellent. Number four, Marla.
Can I borrow your phone? I'd like to call my friend in Australia. Yes, you call him.
Okay, number five, Aide.
Sorry, I can't
care. You would you mind?
Do you mind turning down the music a little? Yes.
Yes.
No.
We don't say yes.
Sure.
We don't say sure. How do you answer these questions? Would you mind? But how do you answer this question? We saw this last Saturday.
Guíete con lo de arriba. Teacher, ¿cómo se dice arriba? Up, 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 up.
Above. Above.
Above?
Yes, above.
Ah, above.
Remember, when you are saying, would you mind, you're asking if the person has a problem doing the thing, doing the favor, or something like that. If you say yes, you are saying that you don't want to do it. So what is a possible answer? Would you mind turning down the music a little?
Not at all.
No, not at all. No, no problem. Okay?
No,
like that? You're saying that you don't have.
Ah, con las cosas de acá.
Okay, let's see. Number six, who? Julio.
Yes. Is it dark in here? Or is it me? Do you mind if I turn on the lamp? No, no, not at all. Sure, go ahead.
Excellent. Number seven, Karina.
Oi, I am starving. Can you make me something to eat? Yes. Do you like sopes?
Ah, okay. That's delicious. Okay, number six, Marla.
Boy, I am
eight.
How I borrow your silver necklace?
Necklace?
I have a big date tonight. Sure. Where will the date?
Where is
the date?
Correct. Questions about the homework, guys?
No, teacher.
No? Bueno, ya me quedo claro. Eso sí was kind of
easy. Ah, yo, teacher, yo.
Yes, tell me, Julio.
A ver, pero en español. Aquí en la de would y if. If es el condicional y would es el, como el auxiliar, ¿no?
Kind of. Only remember when we're using do you mind if we need to use the verb in simple form. When you use would you mind, the verb goes in gerund, I mean with ing.
Okay, okay.
Yes. And remember, do you mind? It's a request, you're asking for something, and would you mind? You're asking for a favor. And that is the difference. Okay, so let's stop here. So I guess that we didn't finish with the lesson, the last part of the lesson. It's okay. Let me look for an exercise. Okay, so here we have some questions, okay? So we're going to practice with this. We are going to ask these questions to each other and you're going to answer them. For example, if I say, Marla, do you mind if I use your phone?
Yes, take. Take it?
Yes.
Yes, you can then take it.
Is it correct to say yes?
Sure. Sure. Go ahead.
No, do you mind?
No? Yes, I'm saying, do you mind if I use your phone?
No problem.
No problem.
You take it?
Yes, you can take it. Or go ahead. Okay, this is question number one. Question number two, let's see, Marla to Aide, please. Number two.
Do you mind if I borrow your book?
No problem.
Okay, Aide, number three to Karina, please.
Do you mind if I join you for dinner?
For dinner.
No problem.
Okay, number four, Karina to Julio.
Do you mind if I call you tonight?
Teacher. Yes, call.
Call Julio. Like making a phone call.
Sure, go ahead.
Sure. Well, you saying, do you mind, remember? How do you answer?
No.
Not on arrow. Okay, and Julio, number five to Judith, please.
Do you mind if I borrow
Who did? Where, listen, who did it, Julio?
Ah,
it's Julio to you. Listen.
Do you mind if I borrow some money?
Uh-huh.
Yes, sure.
No, one more time, who did? How do we answer these questions? Do you mind and would you mind? What are the answers?
Not at all.
Yes.
No.
Okay, Judith, number six to Marla, please.
Do you mind if I copy your homework?
No, not at all.
Okay, Marla. Number seven, Marla, to Karina.
Do you mind if I come to your house tomorrow?
Sure.
Yes.
Yes or no? Okay, Karina, number eight to Aide, please.
Aide, do you mind if I bring me?
Bring my
pet? With my pet tarantula?
Uh-huh.
To class?
To class?
No, at all.
Okay, Aide, number nine to Julio.
Do you mind if you ask your age?
If you or if I?
If I.
If I
ask your age?
Okay.
Julio.
No.
Of course not.
No.
You are. No.
No, not at all. Okay, Julio, number. To Judith.
Do you mind if sits next to you?
Not at all.
Okay, Judith, 11 to Marla, please.
Do you mind if I borrow your pen?
No problem.
And number 12, Marla, to Karina, please.
Do you mind if I open the window?
Sure.
Not at all.
Okay. Correct. I remember that. Did you mind? Okay, and what else? That's what we saw last Saturday. That was the lesson. See, you see, would you mind, and do you mind? Okay, maybe you remember this. This is vocabulary that we also learned in the last lesson. Well, here you, we're going to complete. I think this is very easy for you. For example, picture one, what is it?
Armchair,
and then?
Sofa.
Sofa.
And then?
Table.
Lamp.
Fireplaces.
What is this one?
Where?
The first one on the left. What is
all this? Sure.
You don't remember this one? No?
No.
Bedside. Remember the bedside? The bedside table. Then we have the
fireplace.
Sure. Yes, that is good. Well, let's continue with the book, with the student book. We are going to begin with the Okay, well, here it says in 81 that we need to do the free talk. We're going to do this. We're going to start with the lesson D. When we finish with lesson D, we're going to do the free talk. We have questions and answers. Okay, here we have the lesson D, page 82. It says home habits. We have a reading says discuss these treatments with a partner. How many are true for you? So here we have some activities that we do at home. Let's see, Marla, can you read the first column, please?
I make my bed every morning. Mm-hmm. I do the dishes right after I eat. I organize my books and CDs.
Organize
my books and CDs.
Correct. And Julio, the second part, please.
I always turn off the light when I leave a room. I keep my magazines for about 6 months. I use a dozen different cleaning products.
Okay, so what you're going to do, I just want you to check the things that are true for you. The things that you do, just put a check, please.
Teacher.
Yes.
What mean dozen?
12.
I use a dozen different cleaning products.
Like 12.
12?
Yes, 12. Like the number 12. It's for example when you go to the store and buy a dozen of eggs. Oh, you buy 12 eggs.
Thank you.
Ready?
Finish.
Okay. So let's see, Aide, what do you have?
I do the dishes right after I eat. I organize.
Organize.
organize my books and CDs in that seat.
Okay, how about you, Judith? What do you have?
I make my bed every morning. I do the chores after it. Our tour of the lights where I leave a room. For finish, I use a dozen different cleaning products.
Okay, Karina.
I make my bed every morning. I organize my book and CDs. I always turn off the light when I leave a room. I keep my magazine for about 6 months.
Okay, Marla?
I make my bed every morning. I do the dishes right after I eat, and I organize my books and CDs.
Organize. Julio, don't sleep, Julio. What do you have?
I make my bed every morning. I always turn off the light when I leave a room.
Okay, thank you. Are you comfortable over there, Julio?
Con el chor.
Hi, Julio. Well, let's see. Here we have a reading. It says, read the article, how do your home habits compare with the ones in the article? Well, in this reading, we are going to get some information about what American people do. Okay, what do they do? I mean, talking about home habits. And when we finish, we're going to compare if we do the same or not. So it says, at home, how typical are you? Do you make your bed every day? Do you try to save electricity at home? Are you a pack rat? Read about the home habits of Americans. Are they the same as yours? Well, let's start with the first one. It says, making beds and doing dishes. So, Karina, can you read this part, please?
74%. People make their beds every morning. 5% never do, and 3% actually change their
sheets
every day. You wash the dishes right after eating. 58% of Americans do, but 5% let theirs sit for 2 or more days.
Oh, okay. Well, here it says that 74% of people made their beds every morning. Well, as you were saying, all of you do the same activity, okay, every day. Here it says 3% actually change their sheets every day. How about you? How often do you change the sheets of your beds? How often do you do it, guys? Huh?
What is sheets?
Do you see this picture of a bed? Can you see the picture of the bed?
Yes.
Okay, the piece of clothing that you put on your bed, that is a sheet. So how often do you change the sheets of your bed? Once a week, twice a week, three times a week?
Once a week.
Once a week.
Only Sunday.
On Sundays. Okay, excellent. Let's continue with the second part. It says pack rats. Okay, Aide, can you read this part, please? Pack rats.
How long do you save? Mason's about half the population
throws away all once after 6 months, but 20% keep them for years and years.
Okay, but here it says, imagine half the population throws away all once after 6 months. That means that half of the people try to love to keep their old magazines at home. Do you do the same? Do you keep your old magazines? I mean, or your old books? Karina is like this.
I all see this.
In the middle school, I collect the Rolling Stones magazine.
Oh, so that's the reason why. Okay, and here it says 20% keep them for years and years. So Karina, you belong to that 20%. Maybe. Yes. Okay, let's continue with lights out. Okay, Julio, can you read it, please?
Are you careful about saving electric? 25 of people turn off the light when they leave a room. Eggs never do. Teachers, X percent never do. 4 out of 5 leave the lights on when they go out at night.
So imagine this is that only 25% of people turn off the lights when they leave a room. So how about you? When you leave, for example, your bedroom, do you turn off the lights?
Yes.
Always, because I pay this service.
Okay, that's the reason why, because you pay. Okay, let's continue with neat and tidy. Okay, Judith, can you read it, please? Neat and tidy.
Mm-hmm. Are you an organized person? Person, 13% of people alphabets. Their votes and cities or organize them in some way. The average home has 13 cleaning products around the house.
Okay, now Judith, let's repeat these words, please, Judith. Organize.
Alphabetize.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, this is about being organized. Okay. So imagine this. It says that 30% of people organize their books and CDs in alphabetical order. Do you do that?
No, I don't.
No, I don't.
So none of you?
I don't have CDs.
Or books?
I don't have CDs.
And CDs says that in an average home, we can find 13 cleaning products. That's a lot. Do you do the same? Do you have like 13 different cleaning products at home? Or no? Yes.
Pinol, pot.
Fabuloso.
Okay. No. Okay, let's continue with who does the laundry. Okay, Marla.
Men do 29% of the 419 million loads of laundry washed each week. Almost all unmarried men do at least on the load a week.
Okay. At least.
At least.
One load a week. Okay, here it says that, well, in this case, we're talking about men, only men. It says that only 29% of men do the laundry each week. That means that women do this work. Okay. For example, we have only one guy here in the room, Julio. Julio, do you do your laundry?
No. No.
Yes or no, Julio?
No.
No, Julio?
No.
Why not, Julio?
I have my mom. My mommy.
So your mom does the laundry for you?
No clock.
Yes.
Ay, Julio, Julio. Okay, so before we continue, do you have any questions about the reading?
No.
No, I think it's very easy to understand. Okay.
Okay.
So, well, as you can see here, we were reading about home habits of American people. So, do you have the same habits or yours are different?
Different.
They are the same or different?
Different.
Different. For example, Marla?
Bar rats. Pack rat.
Ah, you are not a pack rat.
Uh-huh.
You are not a pack rat. Okay, how about you, Karina? Do you have similar habits or yours are different?
Yes, similar.
Similar. Okay, Aide?
Similar.
Similar, okay. Judith?
Michu? Michu, similar.
Similar, okay. And Julio.
Ah.
Anda viendo, no sé dónde.
Ajá.
Julio, Julio.
La pajareando.
Yes, I know. Julio looks really relaxed today. Look at him. Okay, let's do the letter C. It says, stealing the missing information from the article, then discuss with a partner. Which facts do you find interesting and which are surprising? So here we have some statements. What you have to do is read again the article and you are going to fill in the blanks, okay? So let's do it, please.
Okay.
Are you ready?
No.
No. Ready, guys? Okay, let's begin. Number one says 74% of people in the US make their beds every morning. Number two, Karina, what do you have?
58% of them wash the dishes right after eating.
Correct. Wash the dishes. Number three, Aide.
Twenty percent of the American overs turn off the light when they leave a room.
Are you sure? 20%?
No.
They never turn off the light.
Eight percent.
Never two. Yes, correct. Number four, Julio.
13 of them organize.
Yes, organize the books. 13%.
Their books and CDs.
And CDs. Okay, number five, Karina.
50% of all Americans save magazines after 6 months.
Save magazines. Is the opposite. Karina. Is the opposite.
Okay. Away?
Aha, throws away.
Yes. 50% of all Americans throws away after 6 months.
All magazines, aha. Uh-huh. All magazines after 6 months. Yes, correct. Number six, Marla.
Almost all unmarried men in the USA do at least one load a week.
Yes, correct. We're talking about the laundry. Okay, perfect. Okay, well, this is a listening. Well, exercise two says evening routines. Do you do any of these things when you get home every day? Tell the class. So here we have some activities that we do at home. Okay, let's look at picture number one. What is the activity in picture one?
Eat.
Okay, it's about eating. Number two?
Letter.
Okay, read the letters, okay? Well, it is, these days we don't use letters, I guess. I don't letters anymore. We used to read the emails. Okay, picture three.
Close.
Open the window.
Yes, yes. Open the window. Yes, open the window. Number four.
I wash.
What?
Shower.
Shower.
Let's continue with the pictures below. Picture one.
Wash the dishes.
I wash the dishes.
Two. The laundry.
Laundry.
Three.
The phone. On phone.
Well, in this case, what is it about? Making phone calls.
Uh-huh, making phone.
What is the person doing?
On TV.
No, we're in picture three. What is the activity?
Calling. Cell phone.
No. Colgando.
What is picture three? No, you don't know?
No.
This person is checking his phone messages. Taking the phone messages. And picture four, that's easy.
Watch the TV.
Yes, okay. Now, in exercise A says, do you do any of these things when you get home every day? Okay, let's see, for example, Marla, which of these activities do you do when you get home after school?
I watch the TV.
Watch the TV only?
Or change my uniform. Change my uniform for my clothes, normal?
Okay.
Normal clothes?
No, you change your clothes. Okay. Let's see, Julio, what do you do?
I watch TV.
Uh-huh.
I take a shower.
And take a shower. Well, let's do the exercise B. It says, listen, what does Mario do when he gets home? Number the pictures above in the order he does things. Is your evening like Mario's? Well, I'm going to play the audio. We're going to listen to this part. Remember, listen to Mario, and you're going to number the pictures in order. Remember, the audios are kind of low, so if you have earphones, try to put on your earphones, please. And we're going to check in a moment. Let me see, page 33.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to listen again?
Yes.
Apaga el micrófono.
Ya.
Se apaga el micrófono, ¿verdad, chamacos?
Yes, I am.
Y la maestra según está... Ay. Digo, no se escucha el audio, se apaga el micrófono.
Yes.
Y la maestra según está poniendo el audio.
No, it's on.
Oh, right. I take a shower, a nice long shower, and change my clothes.
Then what?
Well, then I watch some TV and relax for a while. I mean, half an hour or so. It depends.
And then dinner?
Yeah. I mean, sometimes I watch TV during dinner, but yeah, I have dinner. Something quick out of the microwave. And then I open my mail and read it at the table, if I have any mail.
What do you do after dinner?
Let me think. Not much. Well, sometimes I do laundry right before I go to bed. I just throw my clothes in the washer and let it run while I sleep. And I put them in the dryer in the morning. But that's just once or twice a week.
So when do you go to bed?
Usually around 10. I clean up a bit first, put things away. I try to keep the place tidy. And then before I go to sleep, I read a book or something. And that's pretty much it. Same kind of thing every... Gosh, am I that boring?
So what do you have for number one?
The program continues on the next CD.
Open the window.
Open the window, yes. Open the window is number one. Number two?
Checking all messages.
Huh? Check your phone messages. Okay, that is the number two. Number three?
Washes the dishes.
Yes, wash the dishes. Number three, number four?
They are shower.
The shower, the shower.
Number five?
Owen.
Number five?
The...
It?
No.
Do the laundry.
What do you have for number five?
Owen.
No.
No.
Watch TV.
Watch TV is number five. Yes. Number six.
Eat.
Yes, eating. It's about eating. Number seven.
Do the laundry.
Laundry.
No.
No, the meshes.
Read the letters.
Read the letters.
Read
the letters. Number seven and number eight.
Laundry.
Do the laundry.
Read the laundry.
Do the laundry. Excellent. Okay. Let's continue here. Exercise C. It says group survey. Take turns answering the questions. Take notes on your classmates' answers. Okay, here you're going to ask these questions to each other. So let's see, question number one. Karina, can you ask this question to Marla, please? Number one.
Marla, what do you do as soon as you get home?
What is soon?
As soon means as... How can I explain it? When you get home, what is the first activity that you do when you get home?
Llegar.
That's Spanish. I change my clothes.
You change your clothes. Okay. And then?
Let's eat my shoes.
I watch TV.
You watch TV. Okay. Let's see. Marla, the same question. To Julio, please.
What do you do as soon as you get home?
I watch TV. Have dinner. Yes.
Okay, Julio, question number two to Aide, please.
Okay. Do you change your clothes first?
No, I don't. ¿Cuando llego?
No Spanish, Aide. Julio, you have two questions.
Do you change your clothes first?
Yes. Yes, I do. I change my clothes.
The second question, Julio, you have two questions.
What do you do before you have dinner?
No, Julio. In question two, we have to pay attention. Do you change your clothes first? And below, there is another question.
Do you have a snack before you go to bed?
Julio, again, very number two.
What do you do next?
You have two questions in number two.
What do you do next?
Clothes.
What?
Teacher.
Huh?
The teacher.
The teacher what?
Next.
It says, what do you do next? Hi there.
Ah, yeah.
What are we talking about, Aide?
Eat?
I
eat.
I eat. Okay, I did the same questions to Judith, please.
Do you change your clothes first?
I wash the ham.
Pay attention to the question, Judith. Again, what is the question?
Do you change your clothes first?
Yes, I do.
The next question, okay.
What do you do next?
I drink water.
I drink water.
Water.
Sí. Okay, who did question three to Marla, please?
What do you do before you have dinner?
I wash the dishes.
Wash the dishes. Okay, the same question, Marla, to Karina.
What do you do before you have dinner?
Actually, in my family, I don't have dinner.
No? No. Why not?
In Spanish, because I don't say in English. Bueno, realmente no tenemos como que esa costumbre de cenar. Ajá. Solo almorzamos, o sea, son dos como comidas fuertes. Almorzamos y comemos. Ajá. Pesado, por así decirlo.
Ajá.
O sea, nunca hemos como que tenido ese hábito de cenar. Raramente cenamos pastor, pero las noches no.
Okay, so you don't have that habit. Okay, it's okay. Well, now let's continue, Karina. The next question to who? To Julio, please.
Do you watch TV while you are eating?
Yes, I watch and eating.
And eat. Okay, the same question, Julio, to Marla, please.
Okay. Do you have a snack before you go to bed?
The same question, Julio. The same one. Do you watch TV?
Do you watch TV while you're eating?
Yes, I do.
Okay, let's continue. The next question, Marla, to Judith, please.
Do you do the dishes right after dinner?
Yes, I do. I wash the dishes.
Okay, let's see, Judy, the next question to Aide, please.
Do you do the dishes right after dinner?
Yes, I do.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, the next question, Aide, to Karina, please.
The next?
The next one.
Do you have a snack before you go to bed?
No. No. Not even some cookies.
Ay, cookies.
Nothing.
Only the bomb.
Okay, Karina, the same question to Marla, please.
Marla, what's your bedtime routine?
I get it.
That simple present. What's your bedtime routine?
I don't have bedtime routine. I only bed. No, only go to bed.
You only go to bed and that's it?
Yes.
A bedtime routine means, what are the activities that you do before going to sleep? For example, in my case, I have dinner. Not always. I sometimes have dinner, take a shower, watch TV, and then go to sleep.
Okay.
So how about you?
I take a shower.
Uh-huh.
I wash my cell phone, and last, I sleep.
Go to sleep, okay.
sleep?
That question, okay, Marla, that question to Julio, please.
What's your bedtime routine?
Yes. I exercise.
I what?
And after I do exercise after the bed, go to sleep.
Oh, that's good. He does exercise. Thank you. Yes. Bueno, let's continue with the exercise D. It says use your notes to write a short article about the evening routines in your group. Use the headings below. Well, this is an activity that we are supposed to do according with everybody's information. In this case, it's kind of impossible because we are not together. So you cannot ask these questions to each other. So we're gonna change this part. Evening routines, you're going to write down an article talking about your evening routines, okay? Here we have an example. It says evening routines. And we have three paragraphs, okay? Three short paragraphs. So let's start with the number one. It says first things first. Okay, Karina, can you read it, please?
First things first. Most of the people in our group change their clothes as soon as they get home. One person has some juice or soda first, and then change. We all do different things next. Most of us eat a snack, but one person never eats before dinner.
Okay, let's continue with dinner time. Marla?
Everyone eats dinner at home. Half of us watch TV. Eating. All of us tell to our family during dinner. No one does the dishes right after dinner.
And Aide, time for bed?
Time for bed. All of us watch TV before we go to bed. Some of us go to bed early and some of us go to bed late. After we watch the news, well, I read for about help in her when we go to bed.
Okay, half an hour. Yes, okay. Well, as you can see in this paragraph, well, in this example, this person is talking about his classmates' bedtime routine. As I said before, you're going to write down a paragraph like this one, but it's gonna be about yourselves, okay? Think about your evening routine. It says first things first. Just write down, what do you do before dinner? I don't know, maybe you watch TV, you talk to your parents, you chat with your friends. What do you do before dinner? Dinner time, explain what do you do during dinner. Well, in case of Karina, you say that you don't have dinner. Well, you can omit that part. And time for bed. What do you do right before going to bed? Maybe take a shower, read a book or magazine. Maybe you spend time on Facebook or stuff. I don't know. So try to write down a short paragraph, please. I'm gonna give you 3 minutes, okay? So you can write down, then we can share. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Are you ready, Karina? Yes. Let's wait for them.
Teacher.
Ready, Julio?
Yes.
Yes, Aide. Yes. Marla?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, let's start with Karina. Karina finishes first. So what do you have, Karina? Tell us about your evening routine.
Evening routine? First time first, when I get home, I change my shoes and wash my hands. Then I do my pendants. And last time do exercise. Dinner time, sometimes buy taquitos al pastor. I prepare the table. Voy a soda because my family loves Coca-Cola. Okay, Coca-Cola. I like a Pepsi. When all are eating, talking about this new virus. Time for bed. Always take a shower. Then I take my vitamins for healthy.
Vitamins.
Vitamins. Wash my teeth. Oh, brush my teeth.
Brush my teeth.
And then put my pajamas. Then play in my cell phone and sleep. Finish.
Okay, the first part you say, I do my pendants. Do you mean I do my chores? My chores.
What right
activities that you do at home? Like clean your room, sweep the floor, or mop the floor, do the dishes. Chores instead of pendants. Chores is C H O R E S. And then in another part you said, when all are eating, when everybody is eating.
Everybody.
When everybody is eating.
Is?
Everybody is eating.
Thank you.
And almost at the end you say, I put my pajamas, I put on.
Put on?
Yes, put on.
Okay. Put on.
Perfect, thank you. Okay, let's continue with Marla.
Before dinner, no?
Before
dinner, okay. I take a shower. And I wear my pajama. And I type in with my mom in yours. The room, and I watch TV in the living room or my mother's or in my mother's room, and after wash the dishes, and I wash in myself, and I talk in with my friends, and that's it.
And that's it.
Yeah.
Well, it's very short.
Sí. Yes, it's simple.
So you don't do a lot of things. Okay, Oni, Well, you have only three mistakes. First of all, the pronunciation, you said, I wear my pajamas. I wear.
Wear
my pajamas. And then you say, I talking to my mom. I talk to my mom. Remember, you're talking about routine. I talk to.
Talk to.
My mom. Mm-hmm. And almost at the end, you said, I watching my cell phone. I watch. Remember, when we are talking about routines, we have to use the simple present, not ing. Okay. Excellent, Marla. Julio.
Aquí estoy. First thing first. I confront to work, and after take a break. And after I take a shower, before go to bed, I watch TV and eating. After do exercise, I go to bed late because I do homework the high school, and my father go to bed early.
That's it?
Yes.
It's very brief. Okay, Julio, excellent. That's good. Aide?
Oli. I first things first. I watch TV with my mom. I eating snacks. And after, I read my book. La cabaña. And go to the room. Time routine. I check my cell phone. I take exercise. I take a shower. And talking with my friends.
That's it. Okay, once again, remember, we're talking about routines. We have to use simple present. You say, I eating snacks. I eat some snacks. Simple present, okay? And you finish like this, I talking to my friends. I talk to my friends. Simple present. Okay, and Judith, what do you have?
Time for bed. Yes.
Yes, what is
this? I wash my teeth before I listen music. As I read a book, then I go to my bed. Finish.
I'm going or I go?
I go
to my bed.
Uh-huh.
That is some, but I have seen that most of you have the same situation. You are using present continuous to talk about routines. Remember, we don't use present continuous to talk about routines. We only use simple present, okay? Talk about routines. Yes. Just forget about ing when talking about routines. Well, we need to do this exercise. Number four, it says free talk. Remember, at the back of your book, we have some pages that said free talk. Dun, dun. Remember the pages that are at the back of your book. This is page E. It says free talk 8, all about home. Remember the pages at the end of the book. Thank you.
Page.
I said it doesn't have number. It says E.
Number?
It doesn't have a number. Who did? It's letter E.
I don't have.
You don't have that copy? Julio?
Yes, I don't.
I don't.
Here are the pages at the back of the book. They say free talk. And they have numbers. Free talk 1, free talk 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the free talk number 8. And the page is letter E. This is the page, the letter E. So, can you see the question? Yes, can you see the question? We have the questions here on the screen.
Is this standard?
Yes, it says break up number 8.
Number?
It says 8. It doesn't matter. We have the questions here on the screen. Well, here we have only questions that you are going to ask to each other. It says discuss the questions. How are you alike? How are you different? And does anyone have an unusual answer? So we're going to find out this. This is just a speaking activity. If you don't have that page, well, you can look at the screen. Here we have the questions. So let's start with number 1. As you can see, we have 2 questions at the same time. Okay. So let's start with Julio. Julio, can you ask question 1 to Karina, please?
Okay. What's your favorite room at home?
Can you read both questions, please, Julio? What?
Espérame tantito, Tucho.
Okay, we're gonna change partners. Okay, Marla, question 1 to Karina, please.
What's your favorite room at home and what do you like about it?
Ajá, sí.
No, continúa, Karina.
Ahora te esperas.
Wait, Julio. Okay, Karina, answer.
Wait, my favorite room is the living room. Because I can see the Roquetas Island.
Roqueta Island. Oh, yes, you live in Caleta area.
Yes.
Yes, Caleta Island. Roqueta Island, okay. Now, okay, Karina, the same. Question 1 to Julio, please.
Julio, what's your favorite room at home? And what do you like about it?
My room. ¿Cuál pregunta era?
La azotea.
Ay, Marla.
My room because...
La azotea.
I am only...
Julio, can you get closer to your microphone, please? One more time, Julio, we can hear you.
It's my favorite, my room.
What is your favorite room?
Yes.
No, he's got a problem with the connection.
Teacher.
Yes.
You me escucha, no?
No, we can't hear you.
Why nobody bothers me?
We can hear you. Julio.
What?
Try to get closer with your microphone. Julio.
Hola.
Yes, that's better.
Hola.
Sí, sí, me escuchan.
Yes.
Yes.
Ah. Why nobody?
Okay, first of all, what's your favorite room?
My bed.
Your room. Room.
Yeah. Mm.
Julio.
What?
What's your favorite room?
The bathroom.
The bathroom.
No, no. It's my room.
Your bedroom.
My bedroom.
Why your bedroom?
Why? Because nobody bothers me. I am only.
I am alone.
I am alone. Yes.
Okay, Julio. Question two. Let's see. Two ideas, please.
Yes.
Yes.
What's your favorite pieces?
Piece.
Piece of.
Piece.
Furniture.
How do you say piece?
Wait a second. The second question, Julio. You have two questions.
Where did you get it?
Piece of furniture. What's your favorite furniture? I bet. For I don't know, your bed, the sofa, the TV, the stereo, your laptop.
My phone.
Your what?
My cell phone.
Now let's think about furniture. No, I'm sorry. Your cell phone is a gadget. Furniture, furniture. At home. A sofa, a bed.
My bed.
Your bed. It says, where did you get it? Where did you buy your bed?
Is very common.
Where did you buy your bed? Where? Yeah. Think of a store. Where did you buy your bed?
No sé.
I don't know.
Say the name of a store. Aide.
Aurea.
What?
Aurea.
Okay, how do you say this? The bird. Yes. Try to complete the answer.
I got it at Aurea.
Okay, correct. Question three, Aide, to Marla, please.
Marla, do you have a lot of plants in your home? How about pictures?
Yes, I have a plant in my living
room. Or a lot of plants?
Yes, I have a lot of plants in my living room and what is it, balcony?
Balcony.
Balcon and balcony.
Balcony. And how about pictures?
Yes. I have three pictures in my living room.
Okay, excellent. Okay, Marla. Question number four to Judith, please.
What's your kitchen like? Do you spend a lot of time in it?
Why should you? Yes, my favorite page is stop.
Now, pay attention to the question, what's your kitchen like? We're asking for a description.
No, I don't.
No. Okay, pay attention to this. First of all, this is an information question. We're using what? Every time you see this, remember this is an information question. Every time we have these words, what, who, when, where, how, etc. We don't say yes or no. That is incorrect. We are asking for information. Remember, we are asking for information, so you have to give information. What's your kitchen like? You have to give a description of your kitchen. It's, for example, if I ask you, what's your father like? You can say, ah, he's tall, he's smart, he's street, etc. So your father. This question, what's your kitchen like? You are going to describe your kitchen.
My kitchen is a little.
It's small?
It's small. I had a stove, a table, a barra, no sé cómo se dice en español, barra. Barra de cemento.
Ah, you have a bar.
I watch the dinner play.
Do you spend a lot of time in your kitchen?
No. I cook my daughter.
I cook my daughter, or my daughter cooks?
My daughter cook.
Cooks. Okay. Could it question 5 to Karina, please?
Is there a lot of characters in your bathroom? Who is?
Whose is it?
What is clutter?
Clutter is, for example, like a disorder. Some people in their bathrooms, they like to keep maybe like old magazines or toys if they have children. So is there a lot of clutter in your bathroom? It's like, is your bathroom a mess?
I don't know.
It's about your bathroom. Is there a lot of clutter in your bathroom? Is it messy?
Messy,
yes. Disorganized?
Yes, a lot organized.
Is it organized or disorganized?
Organized.
Okay, so that's it. Okay, number 6. Karina, question to Julio, please.
Julio, what's in your bedroom? Is it neat or messy?
Neat or messy? No sé qué significa.
We can hear you, Julio.
I need teacher.
Julio, again, try to get close with your microphone, please.
I need.
First of all, what's in your bedroom? What do you have in your bedroom?
My bedroom is near neat.
Are you sure?
Yes. Yes.
I remember last Saturday, you showed a picture of your bedroom.
No. Only the bed.
Only the bed.
Yes.
Only the bed.
Yes.
Ah, qué bonito.
So, the first question, Julio, what's in your bedroom?
Okay.
What's in your bedroom?
What's in your bedroom?
Uh-huh.
Is it near or messy?
No. The first question. Answer the question 1. What's in your bedroom?
Oh.
is.
You can say I have, and you mention.
I have my bed.
Uh huh.
Mirror square.
A square mirror.
Square mirror.
Huh?
How do you say peluches?
Teddy bears.
Teddy bears.
Animals. Uh huh.
And clogs.
Uh huh.
That's it.
That's it. Okay. Julio, question number 7 to Marla, please.
Okay. Does your family do a big spring cleaning every year? What do you do?
Yes, with my mom, spring cleaning.
We do.
We do a spring cleaning.
Cleaning,
And arreglar.
Rearrange.
They rearrange the kitchen and living room.
Okay, that's nice. Okay, and question number 8, Marla to Karina. It's almost over. We finished.
Is there a room you like to redecor? What do you like to do?
My bedroom.
Your bedroom. Okay. What would you like to do in your bedroom?
I don't like this color.
You don't like the color.
I hate the orange. Really.
Hey, what color? What color would you like?
Blue or green.
Blue or green. Okay, excellent. Well, this is the last question. Okay, guys, well, it's 10 o'clock. It's 10 o'clock. It's time for your break so you can leave. You can eat something. See you in 20 minutes. Okay?
Bye.
So see you in 20 minutes.
Bye, Chica.
Yes, now it's recording again. So we were with this part, free talk. So we finished with the free talk. So let's see. It was the last exercise. Okay, well, with that exercise, we finished with the lesson D. Well, in lesson D, well, we read an article about home habits. So you were talking about the activities that you do in the evening at home, when you get home after school or work. We did a listening, and at the end, you wrote a short paragraph about your evening routines, and we practice with some questions, okay?
Yes.
So this is the lesson D. This was the lesson D. So we finished with the unit 8. Do you have questions about lesson D, guys?
No.
No. Yep. Okay, so now we're going to begin with a new unit. So we are going to start with unit 9, okay? So this is the unit opener of unit 9. It's called Things Happen, okay? And here we have the learning objectives. It says in unit 9, you learn how to, let me see, Karina, can you read the learning objectives, please?
You learn how to use the past continuous for events in progress in the past.
use myself, yourself, himself, etc. Talk about accidents and things that went wrong. React to the other people's story. Use the expression, I bet.
Okay. Well, as you can see on the first line, we're going to use past continuous for events in progress in the past. So we're going to review in this lesson A, simple past, and we also are going to start using past continuous, both at the same time. So here we have some pictures. So let's pay attention to picture one. What do you see in picture one? Or what is it
about?
A broken cup or a broken face. Okay, it could be something like that. There is something broken on the floor.
Broken.
So let's think about situations in the past. Do you remember a time when you broke something at home? You know, sometimes when we are children, it's kind of common that we are playing ball with our friends. You kick the ball, and what happens? Sometimes you break a window, okay? So do you remember a time when you broke something? A window, a vase, a glass, I don't know, a cell phone?
The last posada in the middle school.
What?
In my last posada.
Uh-huh. What did you do?
In the middle school, uh-huh. I broke the window.
You because broke the window? What were you doing?
Because the palo is...
So you were breaking a piñata?
Uh-huh. Yes, yes.
A mí me rompió la cara.
In English, Aide.
Broken the face.
So you were breaking a piñata and you broke a window instead.
Yes.
Ay, Karina. Did you have to pay for the window?
No, but I have a suspension.
So you were punished for that. Okay, let's see. Picture two. What is it about picture two?
I forgot something.
You forgot something. What do you see in picture two?
Lunch. A lunch.
Our case.
A lunch box.
Forget a lunch.
And what else?
Case. Keys. Car keys.
And the keys. It could be the car keys or maybe the home keys. Yes?
Or sandwich.
Think about one more time. Think about the past. Did you ever forget your keys? Did you ever forget your lunch?
No.
Or you, for example, as a student, it's very common that you get home and you're like, I forgot my homework. I forgot my book. So did you ever forget something?
I forgot cartulina.
Your cardboard.
Yeah.
Oh, and what did you do, Marla?
Nothing. I paid one in my high school.
So you need buy one. So you got another one.
Yes.
Who else had something like that?
I forget the. What do you say, cargador?
Your cell phone charger.
Computer.
Uh-huh. The charger for your computer.
I forget the charger for my computer.
I forgot. Remember, past. I forgot.
The charger for my computer. In this day, I present the project final.
You have to present the final project. And what did you do, Karina?
I do very quickly this project in other computer.
You did again the project.
Yes.
Did you have time?
20 minutes.
Oh, Karina. That is too fast. Okay, picture number three. What is it?
Amal.
Lost something.
Okay, here we have a picture of a wallet. Did you ever lose something in the past?
I lost keys.
The keys.
I lost keys.
You lost your keys.
It's there. Oh, home.
Okay. Another thing, guys.
No. My brother.
Uh-huh.
My brother.
You're right. You lost your brother.
I'm lost in the Zócalo.
I got lost
in the Zócalo.
Here in Acapulco?
¿Mande?
Here in Acapulco?
Yes, Zócalo, en el Zócalo.
How come?
When I am a kid.
When I was a kid.
Yeah.
And what happened, Marla?
My aunt. Estaba con ella. O sea, voy a decir en español.
No. I was with my aunt. And then. You ran or you?
No. Away? I can see. Before. I can see.
You were sick. Uh-huh. And then?
Uh-huh. La perdí de vista. No la pude encontrar.
So maybe both of you were distracted.
Yes.
And then what happened? What about you? Were you scared? Were
no.
you crying?
No.
No?
No.
What did you do?
I stay in the shore. Taxi, the shore.
Where?
In the shore, Zócalo. Hay una iglesia en Zócalo.
So you were outside the church or mm-hmm. inside the church?
Inside.
Ah, so you were inside the church.
Mm-hmm.
Marla. How old were you, Marla?
Yesterday.
Seven?
10 years Seven? Old?
Uh-huh. 7 years.
7 years old. I can imagine. Your aunt. Yes. Okay. Picture number four. What is it about?
Damage.
When you damage something. Did you ever damage something?
Damage something. I.
Tell me.
Shop? Car?
What, Julio?
Shop? Car?
Did you ever damage something?
What mean damage?
Pay attention to the picture of the car. The car is damaged on the front.
Damage.
It's like, for example, your cell phone. If you don't have a cell phone case, and if your cell phone falls down, what happened to your cell phone? You damaged the cell phone.
Damage.
So, did you ever damage something? A cell phone, a toy, maybe?
Well, the first time to visit my grandparents
uh-huh.
in Querétaro,
uh-huh.
the first thing
you did, what did you do?
I damaged this, realmente no sé cómo se llaman, pero son como floreros gigantes que ponen en la sala.
They are faces.
Jarrones, ¿no?
Faces,
ajá. Jarrones. Y I don't know why they put...
they were next to the stairs or...
Next to the escaleras.
The stairs.
Ajá. Well, I... Go to the bedroom.
Ok. arriba. So you went upstairs?
When you go upstairs, uh-huh. I don't see this thing.
You didn't see them.
Sí.
And you broke them.
Yes.
Ay, Karina.
Con ganas de regresarme a la terminal.
And then what happened?
Well, my grandma is very furious with me.
She was furious.
Was furious when I pay with Cola Loca this thing.
Really?
Sí, curiosamente se rompió solo en dos. No se hizo pedacitos.
Oh. Oh. ¿Y se hizo la Cola Loca?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
But the first I put paper.
Paper, uh-huh.
A paper and other capa. Okay.
Like capa, a layer.
Like a layer. Uh-huh. A layer de Cola Loca. Double Cola Loca.
Ay, Karina. No. So try to be careful. Okay, we have the lesson 8. Lesson 8 says, when things go wrong. And we have a question. Are you having a bad week? So tell me your responses, guys. Are you having a bad week or maybe a good week?
Also.
A good week. Excellent.
A good week.
Aide?
Also.
Good También. Week or bad week, Aide?
Good.
I don't know, bad week.
But look at your face. You're like, good. What is that, Aide?
Bad week.
Why, Aide? What the problem is, Aide? You have a lot of homework or what?
A lot of homework.
You have a lot of homework, okay, so that is not good for you. Julio, are you having a bad week or a good one?
Yo estaba en otra página.
What?
A good one?
A good one, excellent. Marla, you said good?
Bad week.
It's great. Karina?
Good? I think good.
It's good, you think it's good? And what it says, it's
good. Good big week.
Excellent.
Great.
Okay, well, here we're going to do a reading. We have three different people. We have Sean Davis, Roberto Moreno, and Julia Chen. They are answering this question. Are you having a bad week? So we're going to read and let's see what happened to these people. So number one, we have Sean Davis. Okay, Karina, can you read it, please?
Sean Davis. Actually, yes, I was going to work on the train Monday morning. And I was talking to this woman. I guess I wasn't paying attention. And I missed my stop. I was half an hour late for a meeting with my new boss.
Mm-hmm. So let's think about Sean. Is he having a good week or a bad week?
Bad week.
Okay. What happened to Sean? What's the problem? He was late for a meeting. Okay. Do you remember why was he late?
Because he was talking to this woman.
Mm-hmm.
And he missed his stop.
His stop, yes, that's the thing. Now let's continue with Roberto Moreno. Okay, Marla, go ahead.
Yeah, kind of.
Kind of?
Kind of. A couple of days ago, a friend, and I were trying to look cool in front of some girls at the mall. We weren't looking, and the week walked right into a class door, and I was embarrassed.
Embarrassed. Okay. Once again, is he having a good week or a bad week?
Bad week.
What happened to Roberto?
Because
he walked right into a glass door.
He walked right into a glass door. Yes, we had the picture over there. Why? What was he doing?
We were trying to look cool in front of the girls.
Yes. So he didn't pay attention to the door. And the last person we have here is Julia Chen. Okay, Julio, start reading, please.
How?
Julio.
Hello.
What?
Hola.
Yes.
Hello.
We were waiting for you.
B, can you shout?
What are you doing?
Okay.
You are not paying attention, Julio. Where are you, Julio? We are reading. Are you on this page, Julio?
No.
Where are you, Julio?
Julio Chen.
He's lost. Okay. So, Aide. Let's read Aide, please. Julia Chen. Pay attention, Julio. Don't get distracted.
Oh, definitely. A friend of mine accidentally deleted my music files yesterday when she was using my computer. I directed for hours to find them. Good morning, worked and lost everything.
Nothing worked. Okay, so
worked.
Is she having a good week or a bad week? Julia.
Bad week?
A bad week. What happened to Julia?
Her friends accident.
All my music or all her music?
Her music.
All her music.
Oh, imagine that situation. Okay. So let me do something. I need this. Okay, let's start with Sean. We have some information about Sean. He says, I wasn't paying attention. Okay, Julia says that his friend was using her computer. Yeah. And then Roberto Moreno says we weren't looking. And there is also another information. He says, I missed my stop. A friend of mine. We have no information. He deleted all my music. By yesterday's 10, Roberto walked right into a glass door. Mm-hmm. Well, as you can see, well, I underlined some expressions in blue and in pink. Pay attention to the expressions in pink. I wasn't paying attention when she was using my computer. We weren't looking, okay? We are talking about activities in the past. As you can see, we're using, I'm sorry, we're using was, wasn't, we can use were or weren't. Okay, we're talking about the past. And also we are using a verb with ing ending, paying, using, looking, okay? Well, this structure is called past continuous, okay? Do you remember when we were using present continuous? I'm walking, I'm drinking, she's reading, etc. That's present continuous. The opposite, past continuous, we're going to use was or were and the verb with ing. Once again, I wasn't paying attention when she was using my computer, we weren't looking. And also we have some expressions in blue. I missed my stop. A friend of mine accidentally deleted all my music files and we walked right into a glass door. In these expressions in blue, if you pay attention, we are using simple past, missed, deleted, and walked. And here we are using both, okay, both tenses at the same time. I wasn't paying attention and I missed my stop. A friend of mine deleted all my music when she was using my computer. We weren't looking and we walked right into a glass door. So here we're saying that we have two activities that happened at the same time in the past. So what is the difference? The activity that we have in past continuous is the activity that happened first. That activity was in process when another activity, I mean a second activity, happened at that time. For example, with Sean, I wasn't paying attention. He's saying that he was talking with a woman. So he was distracted. He was talking with a woman. That activity was in progress. And what happened when he was talking with a woman? He missed the stop, okay? So the first activity is that one. He was talking with a woman. He wasn't paying attention and then he missed his stop, okay? And then with Julia, she says, a friend of mine accidentally deleted all my music files yesterday when she was using my computer. So the activity that was in progress is that the friend was using the computer. Okay, she was using the computer and what happens then? The friend deleted all the files, okay? She erased all the files in the computer. So once again, the first activity, remember, was she was using the computer. And then when she was using the computer, what happened? She deleted all the files, okay? So one more time, past continuous is the first activity, okay? The activity that was in progress. In simple past, we're going to mention the second activity that happened at the same time. Then we have Roberto Moreno. We weren't looking and we walked right into a glass door. So the first situation was that, well, they were distracted, they weren't paying attention, they weren't looking. That's the reason why what happened. They walked into a glass door. Yes? So do you understand this part, guys? Yes or no? Yes, yes. Julio, are you paying attention, Julio?
Sí, sí, escuché.
Are you sure, Julio?
Sí.
Ay, Julio, Julio. Okay. So let me show you something before we continue. So, is here. Okay, well, here we have the information. Yes. Okay, here we have past simple and past continuous. Past simple, what is past simple? We're going to use past simple, remember, to talk about actions or events in the past. For example, when you say, last weekend, I went to Granada. Last Sunday, I just stayed home. Yesterday, I cooked dinner for my family. So we're talking about past events, okay? And here it says we use past simple also to talk about actions or events which happen one after another. We have another example. I visited a cathedral, ate in fancy restaurants, and toured the Alhambra. Okay, so we're talking again about actions that we did in the past. So what is the past continuous? Activities that were already happening at a moment in the past. Here it says that with past continuous, we're going to use was or were plus a gerund. We can use expressions like while or when. We have an example here. We were doing a maths exam in class when my mobile rang. You pay attention. What is the first activity? Well, you were doing your exam. When you were doing your exam, another activity happened. Your cell phone rang. Can you see we have past continuous and we have simple past? The second line says when we are not interested in when the activity started and we don't know if it finished or not. The sun was shining and I was feeling happy. So we were talking about our feelings. And if you pay attention here, we don't have time expressions. I'm just saying the sun was shining and I was feeling happy. When? We don't know, okay? And we don't care about this. And here in lesson A, we're going to use a combination. Mm-hmm. Okay, we can combine the past simple or the past continuous to show that an action happened in the middle of an activity. I was watching television when the telephone rang. So the first activity is watching TV. That activity was in progress. You were doing that activity. And then a second activity happened. The telephone rang. So remember, when you're talking about two activities in the past, for the first activity, we're going to use past continuous. When we want to introduce a second activity, we're going to use simple past. Questions about this, guys?
No.
No? Yes, Karina.
These activities is happen in the one day or one time?
Yes, one time. But remember, these are about past activities.
Oh, okay.
Yes, past activities.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome. Any other question, guys? No?
I was.
Are you sure that you have no questions?
Can I take a picture?
No, I mean yes. Which one, Aide? For this part, Aide?
No.
For this part?
Yes.
Oh, no?
Yes.
You said that you want to take, who says that wants to take a picture? Aide or who? Okay, let me see. Over there. Yes. Aide, you were going to take the picture or not? Aide. Ready? Okay. Let's see. Okay, we wanna do this. So pay attention here. We have some pictures. We're going to complete these sentences using past continuous and simple past. Once again, remember the activity that is in progress. We're going to use past continuous. The activity that happened on second place, we're going to use simple past. Here we have the verbs arrive, crash, fall, leave, paint, frame, read, ring, swim, text.
My gosh.
Watch. Okay.
Wash. Cry, crash, fall, read.
Okay. So let's pay attention to picture one. First, try to think. How can you complete this sentence? We have day, space, TV, when, she, space, home.
They watch TV when she's leave home.
We are using past, continuous, and simple past. Remember.
Watch it.
They're watching TV.
Watch.
Oh, watch.
They what?
Watching.
Watch. They watching?
Watch.
Watch. Only they watch. We are using past, not present.
Watch it? Watch it?
They're watching TV when?
For past continuous, remember we have to use was or were.
They were watching.
Okay, they were watching TV.
TV?
Uh-huh.
They were watching TV. She
when she
leave home. She leave home. Oh, she arrived home.
Yes, guys? Do you have the same? Yes or no? Julio, Aide, Karina?
Yes.
Yes? They were
watching
TV when she arrived home. Arrive home. Okay, now picture two.
She was reading when the telephone rang.
Yes, excellent. She was reading.
Reading when?
When the telephone
rang.
Okay, she was reading when the telephone rang. Mm-hmm. Okay, now here. Number three. What happened?
Pay
attention to the verse. We have arrive, crash, fall, leave, paint, rain, read.
She was arrive.
Text, watch.
No.
Crash.
He was crashing when he
arriving.
What is he doing? What was he doing?
He got
a cell phone.
He talking? Telephone.
Pay attention here to the verbs in the book.
He was texting.
Yes, he was texting. Okay, he was texting. He was texting when
arrived the car.
He crashed the car.
Yes, and he was texting, remember. Hmm. Yes, he was texting. That's the first activity, he was texting. When he crashed the car.
He was texting when they crashed the car.
Okay, let's continue with the picture number four.
He was swimming
when the plane fell into the sea. No. No. The planet.
Crash. Crash. The same verb. Crash
into the sea.
Yes. He was swimming.
He was.
When the plane crashed into the sea. Okay. Yes. He was swimming when the plane crashed.
He was swimming when the plane crashed into the sea.
Now let's pay attention to this. When she, space, the house, eat.
Was she wash?
One more time, pay attention to
wash.
Other verbs.
When she was living?
Living.
When she was leaving the house.
Leaving the house, eat.
Eat. What is the verb that we need?
All.
Pay attention to the verb.
Rain.
It rained. She was leaving the house when it
rained. She was leaving the house running.
When she was leaving the house, it rained. And number six.
He was
crash. He was crash when.
Pay attention to the verse.
What is the pass of fall?
Fell. He was painting when he fell off the ladder.
Irregular verb.
Yes. Remember, we are reviewing simple past also. Questions about this exercise?
On the ladder.
No question? How was the example?
No.
No. Okay, perfect. Never gonna do this. Here we have a picture. Well, here we have some pictures. Okay, look at these pictures. We have 8 pictures.
Okay.
Well, first of all, look at picture number 1. What is going on in picture 1? What do you see?
In their house.
They are in a house. They are having a conversation.
They're reading books.
They are in the living room.
Baby cries.
And the baby's crying, yes. Okay, how about picture 2 with the cars?
Why is it the
robot? No, picture two about the cars.
Yeah.
That is the picture 2.
Crash car.
In the place.
It's like an accident.
Crash car.
Yes, they crash their cars. Picture number 3.
The filler.
Pay attention. The guy is sitting in front of the computer.
He deleted.
It says English homework. What happened?
He delete the
broken computer.
The
broken computer. The CPU.
Computer.
Oh yes, the CPU. Yes, it has a problem. Yes, it's broken. How about picture four?
Playing basketball.
Playing with
the dog. Dog beat
basketball.
The dog back. Beat
the dog back.
The dog
back.
Dog be the bat. The woman.
The dog is biting the woman. Now let's go above picture five. Look at the guy carrying the TV.
To buy TV.
Picture five.
Rob TV.
Stealing.
TV.
Okay, the guy is stealing a TV. How about picture six?
Playing basketball.
What is happening?
It's raining. It's raining in the
pictures.
Volleyball.
Playing? No, it's basketball.
It's basketball. Oh, oh yes, 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 yes.
Picture seven.
She was
the kids
taking shower.
Remember, not shower. Taking a bath. And the telephone is ringing.
The telephone is ringing. It's ringing.
Number
eight.
Ovni.
A UFO. Pay attention. You have
Area 41.
There's an ovni.
Pay attention. You have eight pictures. I want you to choose only four. Okay, choose four pictures. And I want you to write down your sentences. Okay? Choose four pictures and write down your sentences. Remember, you have to use past continuous and simple past. Okay, so let's do it. Choose four pictures. You choose the picture. Use past continuous and simple past, please.
¿Le puede bajar?
How do you say that in English?
Let
me down.
Can you
scroll down?
Scroll down.
Scroll down. Like this?
Thank you.
Yes. Choose four pictures.
Heaven, a UFO.
Yeah?
Heaven.
What are you talking about? Julio. Ay, Julio.
¿Cómo se diría cielos? Sky, un ovni.
Sky.
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 A UFO.
Are you ready, Julia? Finish. Are you ready? Yes, Julian, are you ready?
No.
No? Marla? Yes, who did?
Yes.
Yes.
Four sentences.
Ah, Karina?
Yes.
How many do you have, Julian?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, let's see. Let's start with Karina. Tell me one, Karina, please.
What?
Tell me one.
He was running when he stole the TV.
One more time. He
was
running when he stole the TV.
He was running when he stole the TV. Well, if you pay attention, Karina, in the picture we have two guys. You have two guys. You have the thief and you have the person. The owner of the TV. Only try to change your subjects. For example, you can say the thief, what was he doing? The thief. He was what? Think about the thief. What was he doing?
A person in bicycle?
A person in bicycle. No, we are here with Karina. Okay, this guy. This guy is the thief. What was he doing, Karina?
He was running.
He was... Try to use the second verb. You say stole, try to use steal in past continuous. He was...
He was stealing.
Stealing. Or the thief was stealing the TV. Yes, the thief was stealing the TV when, look at the other person, when, you can use her name, when Julio, when Oscar, when Pepe, I don't know.
Benito.
Okay, when Benito, simple past, when Benito.
Robin?
Pay attention, we have a house. When Benito
arrived.
Mm-hmm.
When Benito
arrived.
Home.
Okay, now you have your sentence. The thief was stealing the TV when Benito arrived home. Yes? And that's it. Okay. Thank you, Karina. Okay, Aide.
She's taking a relaxing bubbly bath.
Number 7.
Yes.
She was taking,
a relaxing bubbly bath.
Bubble bath?
Bubble bath.
Mm-hmm. And what happened, Aide?
That's it.
No, what happened? Pay attention outside. To the telephone. What happened? The first sentence is correct, Aide. She was taking a relaxing bubble bath when?
When?
What happened with the telephone?
The telephone rang.
Okay. The telephone?
Rang.
Yes, in past. Excellent, correct. She was taking a relaxing bubble bath when the telephone rang. Excellent. Yeah. Okay, Marla.
They were reading books when the baby cried.
Okay, they were reading books
mm-hmm.
when the baby cried.
Cried.
Excellent, Marla. That's perfect. Okay, Julio.
A ver. Then we're talking about the school.
Who?
Then we're talking about the school.
They were talking about the school?
Number one.
Mm-hmm. And? You have what? Two situations.
The dog was borrowing a shield.
Uh-huh.
That's it.
Okay, but pay attention. Look at the lady. The lady is doing something. What is she doing? What is the lady doing? She's standing outside of a store. What is she doing?
Scarlet. Scarlet.
No, what is she doing? Look at the lady.
Watch the animals.
How about look?
They was the shoes.
It's screaming.
Now, first of all, pay attention to the picture. Once again, the lady is outside of a store and she's looking.
Shoes.
What? Okay, so we can say the lady or the girl was looking. What did you say, Marla?
Shoes.
Okay. The girl was looking some shoes when, now what happened with the dog?
Was budding.
Now, but pay attention. In your first sentence, you are using was because it's past continuous. The girl was looking at some shoes when, your second sentence, you need only simple past. When a dog, what did he do, the dog? What did he do, the dog? How do you say murder in past?
Bite.
Bite is
present.
Bit.
Bit.
Beat her.
Okay.
Beat her. The girl was looking at some shoes when a dog beat her. Yes?
Yes.
And let's see who did.
Picture C. They were playing basketball.
They were playing basketball.
When he started to run. Okay. Started?
Once again, who did, they were playing basketball when?
When it started to run. Empezó a llover. To rain.
Yes, excellent. Who did, you are correct. Perfect. Questions, guys, about this? Are you sure? Okay, Julio, we'll see you in a moment. Well, now let's continue with the student book. We were with the student book. Okay, we're here. Okay, now we're going to do the exercise B. This is page 86. Can you choose the correct verb to form these sentences? Use information above to help you. Okay, you can read again, okay, the article above. Or if you remember, only read the sentences and underline the correct words. Okay, let's do it, please. We are doing the exercise B, Julio, on page 86. You have three sentences. Read the sentences and underline the correct words, Julio. Okay. Page 86, the student book.
Okay, okay.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
Yes. Are you ready, Aide?
Yes.
Yes.
Estaba haciendo la última.
Yes.
You were doing the last one. Okay, thank you, Judith. Okay, number one, Judith. Can you read it, please?
Mm-hmm. Sí.
Number one.
Uh-huh. Sí, talk.
Sean.
Wash, talk. Sean, talking. Ah. No. Sam was talking a woman on the train and he missed his stop.
Okay, he missed.
He missed, huh?
He stopped. Okay, thank you, Judith. You're correct. Number two, Karina.
Julia's friend deleted her files when she was using Julia's computer.
Excellent. Number three, Marla.
Roberto and his friend were trying to look cool when they walked into a class door.
Okay, they walked
into a class door.
Okay, it's walked.
Walked.
Imagine that you have a T at the end. Walked.
Walked.
Mm-hmm. Yes, there is a walked. All right. Okay, now let's continue with the second page. It says grammar. We have the past continuous statements. It says use the past continuous to set the background for a story or tell about events in progress in the past. Use the simple past for completed actions in the past. So we have here some examples. I was talking to a woman and I missed my stop. I wasn't paying attention. So the activity that was in progress is that he was talking to a woman, he wasn't paying attention, and what happened? He missed his stop. Number two, we were trying to look cool and we walked into a glass door. We weren't looking. So the first activity was that they were trying to look cool to some girls. That's why they weren't looking. And what happened? What is the consequence? They walked into a glass door. Then it says, a friend of mine deleted all my files when she was using my computer. Again, the activity one is the person using the computer. The second activity, he deleted all the files. And the last one, when my friend was using my computer, she deleted all my files. Okay, so we have the same information. We have the different order, but it's the same information. Okay, so once again, questions or doubts about the grammar chart?
I don't know.
No.
No. No.
Well, excellent. Now, let's do the exercise A, please. Here it says complete the anecdotes with the past continuous or simple past. And you're going to use the verbs in parentheses. Okay, so let's do it, please. Let's complete this part. Are you ready?
Finish.
Finish, okay. Are you ready, Marla, Ide, Julio, Karina?
Ya, ya casi, ya estoy en el final.
Almost, almost. Julio.
No, todavía no.
Not yet, okay.
Creo que ya.
Creo que ya, or I think so. I think so. Ready, Julio?
I think so.
I think so. You think so, okay. Well, let's see number one. Okay, Marla, can you read number one, please?
Number one.
Marla, Marla.
A few wings out. When I was making dinner, my friends calling. I was calling.
My friend, I was calling.
Call it.
Oh. Call it. Call.
Call. I completely forget about the food on the stove and the burning everything.
Let's see. So your friend, my friend, call. Mm-hmm. I completely forget.
Cold.
Forget or forgot?
Forgot.
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 About the food and the stuff, and I
burned everything.
Burned everything. Number two, I
bet. I wear daming.
I wear what?
Damage?
No, it's a last week. Last week, it's for simple past. You need simple past only.
I damage.
Damage.
Damage?
my parents' car last week. I was driving to work and I
you're saying I was driving to work and the second activity is simple past.
Run.
What is the past of run?
Run.
Into a shop thing.
Now
I have to pay for the repairs.
Number three, Julio.
Yes. Okay. Last week, I hurt.
Where are you? Last week,
I hurt. Es lo mismo. Es que no me sabía su...
What are you doing, Julio?
El pasado de hurt es wounded.
Okay, last week I hurt my foot.
I hurt my foot when I was do.
I was do. I was do.
I don't. I
don't. I was doing.
I was doing.
Uh-huh.
Aerobics. I don't know why, but I just felt. I felt so stupid.
Yes, correct. Number four, Marla. No, Marla. Karina.
Yo.
Karina, wait a second, Karina.
I was half lunch.
I was having. Yes.
I was having lunch in a restaurant yesterday when the server accidentally
spilled
water all over me. It was embarrassing. But then I was getting my lunch for free.
Simple pass. Only simple pass. Then I?
Get?
Got. Simple pass.
Got.
Yes. Then I got. Yes. Simple pass. Then I got my lunch for free. And number five, put it.
My friends were talking in class. And we wasn't paying attention. So then we realized.
One more time, put it. And we, it says nothing. In past.
The past. And we pay.
It's negative, but in past.
No pay.
No, negative form, in past.
No pay.
No, Judit, remember we need to use an auxiliary. What is the auxiliary that we use for simple past?
Wash.
No.
Washing.
No. What is the auxiliary for simple past? Who knows?
No. Did?
In negative?
Didn't pay attention. Suddenly, we realize the teacher. We sit down.
The teacher was
What's in the
standing?
Standing. Uh-huh. What's standing? Right beside us. He and the home class listening.
We're listening.
Listening. To
we're
us.
Listening.
To us. Listening. To us.
To us.
To us.
Uh-huh. To us. Yes, the whole class were listening to us. Uh-huh. Okay. I like that. Okay. Do you have questions about this, guys? Doubts?
No.
No? Okay, so this is the exercise, okay? Well, now let me...
Listen and listen to us.
Let's continue with the second. I have another exercise in a second. Oh, no. Use the reflexive pronouns. Okay, well, let's review just past continuous. Okay, only past continuous here. Remember, in past continuous, we have to use was or where only. Let's look at this picture. We have like a schedule. We have Jake and Jake's father. We have times and we have the activities. On top, we have the verbs. Play soccer, wash dishes, prepare breakfast, play a guitar. Play computer games, do the laundry, wash the car, play with the dog, swim in a pool, and get up. We have an example, number one. The question is, what was Jake doing at 8 a.m.? So we have Jake. He was getting up, okay? He was getting up at 8 a.m.
He question was?
Two. Yes. Question two, what was Jake's father doing at 5:30?
He was playing soccer.
Jake's father.
He was playing.
Okay, you have the soccer verse in the box. No, Jake's father.
No se alcanza a ver, profe.
Se ve borroso.
Oops.
Se cayó el señor.
¿Cuál?
He was shower car.
He was shower the car. Okay, this one. Here we have wash the car.
Wash the car.
So he was...
Wash the car.
He washed.
He was wash the car. It's correct.
Washing?
Washing. Remember he again, washed. You're using gerunds. He washed, washing the car. And number three, this is for Aide. What was Jake's father doing at 11:15 a.m.?
I watched the computer.
11:15, Jake's father.
Ah, yeah. I know.
He
ajá, ¿y de?
Es que no se ve qué es.
Yes.
Dishwasher.
We have the verse in the box, please, Julio.
He was.
Okay. Okay, let's see Karina. Karina was the first one. Ah, Karina.
He was washing dishes.
Yes, he was washing the dishes. Yes, he was washing the dishes. Okay, Julio, number four. What was Jake doing at 2 p.m.?
He was taking a shower.
Julio, pay attention to the verse in the box.
Ah, no los había visto. Swimming.
He was swimming
in a pool.
Correct. Okay, number 7. Who did? What was Jake's father doing at 2 p.m.?
He was watching the clothes.
No, pay attention to the verse again. Remember, you have the verse in the box.
He was watching watching.
Again,
who did?
Use the verse in the box.
Boy.
Yo.
He was doing the laundry.
Yes, he was doing the laundry. I'm sorry, Hayden. Okay, number 8, Karina. What was Jake doing at 7:45 p.m.?
Jake? Only Jake?
Yes, only Jake.
He was playing the guitar.
Correct. Okay, let's see. Hayden, number 9. What was Jake doing at 5:30 p.m.?
He was
Okay, that's the easiest one. Hayden.
Es que se me borró el nombre.
You have the name, Jake. What was he doing at 5:30 p.m.? You don't know, I did.
Sí, tengo el nombre aquí, pero se me olvidó.
Okay, who did? What do you have, Judy?
He was playing with the dog.
No, 5:30 p.m. What is 5? 5:30 p.m.
He was playing soccer.
Yes, he was playing soccer. Excellent. He was playing soccer. And the last one, Marla. What was Jake's father doing at 7:45 p.m.? Jake's father.
He
was playing with the soccer.
The soccer?
The dog.
Playing the dog.
The dog. He's playing with the dog. Okay. Questions again, guys? Okay, we're going to stop here. We're going to continue next weekend. We're going to have to do the speaking naturally. And we're going to continue with the lessons B and C next weekend. So the homework, well, you're going to do in your workbook the lesson D. And lesson 8, I mean pages 64, 65, 66, and 67, okay? 64, 65, 66, 67. That is your homework for next week, right? Questions about the lesson